Hello! In this tutorial, I'll show you how to quickly conduct a feasibility study, including massing and statistics in Revit, using Plannery 3. We will go over the key features that will get you started with Plannery in no time. This includes creating parametric sites and buildings, integrating a 3D context map, and exporting the massing, levels, and Excel data file. The plugin is available for a free trial. You can download it from our product page, linked in the description below. We begin with a basic drawing. I'm going to draw my site using property lines and sketch my building with filled regions. Each filled region represents a part of the building. In this example, I've got a podium and a tower. Next, I'll head over to the Add-ins tab and launch Plannery. To add our first site, I will right-click in the Plannery view, click Add Site, and pick the property line from Revit. Once the site is selected, I can rename it and add comments under the properties. To create the first building, I'll right-click on the site and select Add Building from the dropdown. Then, back to Revit to pick the filled region of the first building part. Under Properties, I can name the building and change the site associated with my building. Under the Building Part properties, I can change the name, set the number of floors and their heights, and assign the Use and Building section. Changing the height for a specific floor is easy. I'll adjust the first floor to be 8 meters high and designate it for retail use. The next step is to add a building part above. I will right-click on my building part and select Add Building Part Above. I'll go back to Revit and pick a filled region for the tower. In the properties, I'll rename it to Tower. This building part will be a 22-story residential. I can always edit my drawing in Revit, and the updates to statistics and massing will be reflected in real-time in Plannery. To add another building to our site, I'll draw a new filled region. Right-click on my site again and add a building. We can also add land and outdoor spaces to our project on our site. Just right-click, choose Land, and back to Revit to select the filled region for the outdoor space. I'll rename this to Open Space and set it as Greenery. I can also adjust the thickness. My project's analysis is dynamically updated in real time on the Analysis dashboard. It displays a set of metrics, including gross floor area, site area, floor space index, building coverage ratio, total height, number of floors, net saleable areas, unit count, parking, and the unit mix. Additionally, the Area Distribution tab offers a detailed view of how the building area and land use are allocated. It breaks down the distribution both by percentage and by area. To exclude an element from the analysis and the view, I can right-click on one of the building's elements and choose Exclude Building. This means the building will be excluded from the total calculations and also when I export data or massing later on. Plannery lets us set a location and view our project in a 3D context map. To place the project on a map, I will select the map type first. On the map properties, I can type the address or use geolocation. With the place marker on map, I will select the point to place my site. By clicking Change Site Base Point, I'll create a base point to link my Revit drawing to the Plannery map. I can adjust the site to the map using the rotation tool and change the marker location at any time. By clicking Place 2D Map, I can bring a satellite image directly to my Revit view. As you can see, the image will be placed on the exact location. I can change the 3D map style. In edit mode, I can hide existing massing. I can also add a topography layer and street names. Under preferences, I can customize the project's parameters and the calculations for key metrics. This flexibility allows me to adjust everything from project units, building spaces, parking and land use, to the unit mix and view styles. I can easily create a new design option by right-clicking on the project tab and choosing Duplicate. This gives me a copy of my project that I can modify, allowing me to explore different design scenarios. To save a new camera position, I will click Save View. If I need to delete or rename the new camera, I can go to Manage, where I can delete or rename it, and then click OK. To create an angular plane, all we need to do is draw a detailed line in Revit, right-click on the site, and select Add Angular Plane. Then pick the line from the Revit view. Under Properties, we can give it a name. Change the length of the projected plane, the angle, the thickness, and the offset from the ground level. In Revit, we can drag and move the line and change the angular plane location and size. To create an underground parking in Planary, I'll draw a shape using a filled region in Revit and make a new building part. In the Properties section, I will set the Use to Underground Parking and ensure the Underground checkbox is selected. This action positions my building part below ground level. In Planary, I have the option to export the massing into Revit. I'll go to File, Export, Mass into Revit. We're going to name the massing and select the corresponding level. Planary will generate a Revit mass for each building and place it in the exact location of the filled regions. To generate levels, I'll go to File, Export, and choose Levels into Revit. Planary will create a set of levels per building. To export data to Excel, I'll go to File, Export, Excel Data File, and Save. Planary will create an Excel sheet of our project, summarizing the statistics, giving us a breakdown of our sites and our buildings. Thanks for watching, and keep following for more tutorials.